In the spotlight this morning, there is a new pop group taking over, girls. After playing at their local pubs in Australia and uploading some videos to YouTube, the pop rock band At Sunset is quickly rising to fame here in the U.S. Check out a clip from their single, Back in Time.
I don't know what to say, but it doesn't matter anyway. I don't know what to think, 'cause she might not even feel the same. I'm thinking if I go back, I could replace this empty space. I wanna go back. Here we go, running back in time. My heart still beats at the speed of light. I've been searching through my mind to find a map that'll take me back in time.
That song's going to be going through your head the rest of the day. The band's joining us here this morning in studio. This morning, we are welcoming Harrison Kantaris, Andrew Kantaris, and Tom. Good morning, guys.
How you doing?
He's just going by one name, just Tom. Just Tom. Great to have you guys here today.
Thanks for having us.
Can we talk about the power of YouTube? Before, guys like you would have to go find a record company. You'd have to go into a studio and start recording. Bands don't have to do that anymore. YouTube has really taken over as far as getting exposure.
Correct, yeah. And the cool thing is, if you can generate the fans on YouTube as well, they become the label. They start making the decisions for you, and you talk to your fans and see what they want, and that's your next move. So that's what the cool thing is about it.
And I was reading one of the videos that you guys put up. It was just a couple of days, had hit like 500,000 hits within like 2-3 days. TV shows don't get that watching in one night.
I guess we're very lucky that we've got, I mean, when it first started, we had 100 girls liked the video, but those girls, this is why people thank their fans, because those girls literally just shared it around, and now you get 1,000 views, and then they share it to 1,000 friends, and it's sort of just, and
they
can't do anything but thank those people that get it out there.
And you're talking about driving the machine. You're not kidding about driving the machine. We just sent a tweet out saying that you're going to be here. We have requests coming in from Australia, from girls who are just obsessed with the band and who are just happy that, you know, they're going to be able to see this later on or streaming it online right now.
That's pretty insane.
What is that like?
It's crazy. You know, I think it's like midnight in Australia right now, so that's even more insane. But yeah, you know, the fans are everything to us, and they really push us to do our best, and we do it for them.
All right, let's talk about the music itself. Who are you guys comparing to? I read a bunch of our articles on it, and they're saying, you know, almost like One Direction. Is that the direction you want to go in, or is it a whole other thing?
I think it's kind of, we love One Direction, The Wanted, all bands like that. They're amazing.
And if you can hit that kind of fame, go
exactly
for it.
Exactly right. Absolutely. You know, if we get to One Direction status, we're not going to complain about it. But I think we're pretty similar to the Jonas Brothers, maybe. It's a bit new age rock pop as well, so it's something a bit different that we encourage people to come see our show and then make your mind up about it.
And what is it like for the first time? I will never know, being part of a boy band, what that's like, or a bunch of guys in the band. What is it like the first time you guys actually take the stage and there's that crowd of people screaming like maniacs?
You get a hit of adrenaline.
It's insane.
Yeah. It's just this big spark of it, because you practice in your bedroom, but then in the studio, and you practice over and over again, but nothing compares to actually jumping on stage, because you just vibe off the audience. It's
100%.
Amazing.
All right, and you guys were also telling me your record is being played on iHeartRadio.
Absolutely.
You've done stuff for Seacrest.
Yes.
You're on Sirius XM.
Yes.
All over the country. Hearing your song on the radio for the first time, mind blowing?
Insane. Like, you can't explain the feeling.
The lyrics you wrote in your bedroom, and then driving in the car in another country that you've never been before, and then all of a sudden that song to come on is just unbelievable.
It's insane, man.
And let's talk about being here in the U.S. You guys were talking to Michaela and I and Brendan this morning about the craziest things that are blowing your mind America.
You drive on the other side of the road.
That makes no sense.
Every time.
Why are you on the other side of the road?
I was laughing this morning because you said every time a truck comes your way, you're freaking out.
Yeah, we all literally do that at the same time.
What has been the best thing about being here in the U.S.?
Free refills.
Soft drink refills, or soda. In Australia, we call them soft drinks.
God bless America for free refills.
Free refills.
There you go. That says it all. It should be right on the Constitution.
We got off a 14-hour flight. We went to Six Flags.
Yeah. So nice.
That was really cool. We love roller coasters, so that was pretty insane.
That's fantastic. All right, we've got just a little time. You guys are actually going to sing some a cappella for us, right?
Are we?
Yeah, well, that's what I was told. That's what they're telling me. So I want to just sit here, and you guys can take it away.
Cool. All right. This one's our single. It's called Back in Time.
Here it is. No instruments.
Do you want to play a note or something?
Now I got it.
You ready, bro?
Ready.
Okay, cool.
Now we're running back in time. My heart still beats at the speed of light. 'Cause I've been searching through
to find a map that'll take me back in time.
Nice. See, I could have done that if I wanted to.
You were just in the back.
I was over here.
I could hear you.
So what is next for you guys?
I think the next thing is to get over to LA and do all the radio that we've got set up there. But then after that, hopefully come back and do a summer tour. I think that's the plan. And that'll be the cool thing for us, is to get our music out there and come play for everyone.
Absolutely.
So good look stuff. Out for that.
Well, I'm glad you guys came in here. It's great having you here.
Thank you
when
so
you
much
get that One Direction fame, whatever fame, you come back here to Rhode Island.
We will.
The guy Mike can hook us up and bring you back in here.
We love you guys.
Thanks so much for being here today.
And if you want to learn more about At Sunset, all you got to do is head over to the Rhode Show page. It's WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.